Hey guys, welcome to my kitchen. Today we're going to be cooking a butternut squash and black bean stew kind of chili together because this month in February, the harvest of the month vegetable is winter squash, and there's different kinds of winter squashes, and one of them is a butternut squash. So this is what the butternut squash looks like, kind of like a baby, perfect size. So anyways, butternut squash is great for a ton of reasons, one of which is that it has a ton of vitamin A, which is really good for your eyes, and it's also really great for your immune system. So, you know, with COVID and with the flu and with any other kind of sickness that's going around, getting some butternut squash in your diet is definitely going to help keep your immune system strong and try to keep you defended from, you know, any germs that are around you. So if you come a little closer, we can take a look at the different ingredients that we're going to use today. So in terms of our produce, so that would be fruits and vegetables, you guys should all recognize this as garlic because we planted that together. This is not a random leaf. This is called a bay leaf. It's really, really great for soups and just adding a lot of flavor to a dish. And then we have bell peppers. We have a red onion, the butternut squash, and half of an avocado that I ate the other half this morning. So we can also have some cilantro if you want to top it with that at the end. And then here we have some olive oil, some vegetable broth. Those are some black beans and some tomato. And then here we have some different spices. One of the great things about this recipe is that you can kind of make it however you want. All you really need is the butternut squash, the tomatoes, and the black beans. And from there, you can kind of take it in whatever direction you want. So you can add whatever spices you might at home. You could add any kind of protein. So something like chicken or beef. For me, I'm gonna make it vegetarian. But totally feel free to take this recipe in any direction you want and just have fun with it. The first thing that we need to do before we cook anything is we need to prepare everything, which is one of my favorite parts of cooking because I love chopping vegetables. So if you usually don't get to do this, ask a parent if they can either help you or show you how to do this. I'll also be using a closer up camera. We're about to switch views to like an overhead kind of view. And just give it a try. Definitely be careful when you're holding knives because you can get cut. But yeah, so we're gonna now switch into preparing all the vegetables before we cook them. Onions are great for a lot of reasons, but yes, you might cry when you're cutting it. So what you're gonna do is you're just gonna chop off this top part. And you can, some people leave this bottom part on. I'm personally just gonna take it off. And then you're going to peel away all of the skins, set them off the board, and then you can cut it down this way again. Here you want to remove just kind of this whole outer layer that's going on. I might have taken a little bit too much, but that's okay. Just remove this one. And even if it doesn't look the most pretty, like here it has a little bit of spots, that's okay. We're putting it in a stew, so it really doesn't matter. And we are going to chop them. So I'm assuming that's just gonna mean having them like this. And then we're just gonna chop. Here's where you gotta be careful with your fingers. So I'm gonna turn it over this way now. I'm just gonna chop here. Move that over and do the other side. There we have the onions. So we'll kind of set those over there. And what we're gonna do with these is we are going to grab a pot. I'm going to put a little bit of olive oil in it and then add the onions. The recipe calls for 2 tablespoons of olive oil, but you can kind of just eyeball this part. So I'm gonna take some olive oil. I'm gonna turn this on a medium heat. So maybe about a 5 if your stove has numbers. If not, just put it on medium. Add some olive oil. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect. It just has to taste good in the end. Next thing that we're gonna do is we're going to chop the bell peppers. As I'm chopping the bell peppers, I'm also gonna turn the heat down on the stove just a little bit to low until we add all the other ingredients. I got a little excited there. You're gonna just cut the top off and then you're gonna go around here. You're gonna remove the center like this. And then you can kind of take your hand, twist it a little bit, and it should come out like that. And then you can put that to the side. Also, you can use any color of bell pepper that you want here. This one calls for red just because red, I think, is the sweetest bell pepper. But you can use whatever colors you have. I'm gonna put it this way. If you want, you can remove this little part. And again, this doesn't have to be perfect. So, fun fact about bell peppers is that they are the only pepper in the pepper family that doesn't have this compound that's called capsaicin or something like that. And that's the compound that makes peppers spicy. So that's why bell peppers are sweet. Sometimes they're called sweet bell peppers. So yeah, they're the only non-spicy pepper. Add this pepper and then we'll do the other pepper. Look at that. Okay, so this is a very pleasant surprise. Sometimes this happens with peppers, is that, see, this little green guy is a baby. So we've been learning about seeds and everything. So this is one of the seeds that has just decided to start growing. But yeah, that's awesome.